What's happening? Where am I? Damnable cage. Damnable cage. Wretched thing. You got what you deserved. On my way. Don't mind if I do.
Visions project into your mind. A Nautiloid hurtling through the plains, resplendent with psionic energy.
Yes, let's. A quick rummage. How about this?
Visions project into your mind. A Nautiloid hurtling through the plains, resplendent with psionic energy.
This is the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye. The casing is fragile. The slightest touch could cause it to crumble.
I feel good. Rejuvenated.
Sus.
A schematic of a Nautiloid flashes into your mind.
We are
nerves,
here.
Sinews. As yeah. Much living being as ship. Images of goblins, their habits and histories flash into your mind.
Help us.
Let's have it.
Release us. You've come to save us from this place. From this place you'll free us.
The exposed brain quivers in expectation.
Please. Before they return! They return. The enemy. So many enemies.
A newborn.
Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer, a minion of the mind flayers who abducted you.
Remove us.
From this body. From this case.
Free us.
From the skull, but you notice an opportunity.
You could cripple the strange creature, making it more subservient, should it prove a threat. Pauses, listening. Something behind your eyes seizes in recognition.
We must go to the helm.
At the helm, we are needed. Us. We are us.
The brain tenses, as though querying an unseen advisor.
Do you not hear it? We will not survive here. We are needed to
navigate.
We are needed to leave this realm.
To the helm we go!
We are going to the helm.
Let's see here.
Tread lightly.
Visions rush past. A dragon's wing, a silver sword, and a flash of your face seen through the strange woman's eyes.
Oh, my head. What is this? Squaw. You are no thrall. Vlakith blesses me this day. Together, we might survive. We carry Mind Flayer parasites. Unless we escape, unless we are cleansed, our bodies and minds will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geth, Mind Flayers. We can do nothing until we escape. That must be our priority. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. As for that thing, it will remain tame as long as it believes we are thralls. It may be of use in the fight to come.
Time to strike. This is your end.
You proved surprisingly adequate in battle. Now, to the helm.
There. Step at a time.
The ship can only take so much. We have to push on before those dragons bring us down.
Without knowing its purpose.
You! Get me out of this taxi!
We have no time for stragglers.
Construction is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
This ship is crashing. Do you intend to die for a stranger?
Try that contraption next to the pod. They did something to it when they sealed me in. Hurry! Please!
Console appears dormant. The mechanisms are completely unrecognizable at first, but then you spy an empty socket.
I can't turn it on. Not without whatever fits in that socket. Oh. brain. How delightful.
Faint images appear in your mind. A brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness. Console appears dormant. The mechanisms are completely un.
Skrull. How many hosts of these Geth infected?
As you place your hand on the pod, you hear something. A presence connected to the pod. Commanding the person inside to change.
Changer changed at the pull of a lever. How? If we are not purified, this may be our fate.
Is there a lever with our names on it somewhere? Curious. Looks like it might fit into that machine. Are you a pet or a snake?
Flayer stares at you, weak and dazed.
What are those voices? Hello?
I hear nothing of the sort.
Console appears. The console hums to life. But what is its purpose? Will it free the captive or transform her like that other unfortunate? Of the device make it seem more like a beating heart than a machine. This device is different from the one that caused the other captive to transform. Perhaps it will open the nearby pod. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. A parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. You feel the biomechanical brain of the console process your command and yield to it. A shiver runs across your mind. You feel sated.
To the helm. We must go.
It's uncooperative. Pulling that lever may have been a mistake. Time to kill. Mind if I do? Step lightly.
We are nearing the helm. Once inside, do as I say.
Deal with the Geich after we escape.
Connect the nerves.
Nerves? We will connect them.
Let me betray her!
She's going down. Get out!
Make it hurt.
Worth examining.
Take this ship, or Zarya will have your head!
Let's grab what we can.
cold grip.
Taking position.
Throw the torches in the sticks.
This way. To the death.
Come a little closer.
mine is mine.
Bloody mind players! I need to get to that transponder.
Step quick.
It's clear. Hurry! Before they strike!
On the way.
Ha!
Helm's alien transponder. You've made it in time. Sunlight. Your first instinct is to flinch from it and hide in the safety of the shadows. But to your astonishment, there is no pain. The opposite, in fact. Your skin tingles pleasantly, like the caress of a lover who doesn't know any better yet. But beneath the skin, flesh and bone, there is a much more unpleasant sensation. Something nibbles and burrows where it does not belong. The tadpole. Nestled in your brain. Your stomach rudely announces itself to you with a twinge. Unfortunately, you cannot eat sunlight. Time you found some prey. And of course, you'll be feeding for two now, thanks to your guest. Until it deigns to feast on your brains and split you open to reveal a newborn mind flayer. Perhaps it would be wise to focus on finding a cure. As wonderful as the sun is, you can hardly enjoy it if your face rips open.
Moving.
Running water normally burns like acid, but now, who knows?
Mm.
You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. You might want to reconsider calling her a friend. Looks like she ran off without us. You're more concerned for her than she is for you, clearly. We need to take care of ourselves. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other, and we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Someone there. This way. A little souvenir. Let's hope for gold. I'll just help myself. More of those wretched things.
that open easily. Maybe there's another entrance.
With pleasure.
I like it. Homely.
It looks like a trap.
Someone doesn't like visitors.
Yes, please. Subtle steps.
An iron coin. I prefer gold.
Looks like a trap. My faith will guide me.
Keep a blade close.
Someone doesn't like visitors.
Whatever it takes.
Let's see here. I wonder.
Scribes with swords? So much for the quill being mightier.
I wonder what was so subversive about their words that they commanded protection.
Thank you. chained book. Oh, that's just begging to be read.
This way.
Jurgle? This must be ancient. No one worships the final scribe.
Inscription is in a language unknown to you.
What am I to do? No time for dally.
Just woke up.
Need to stay focused.
time has come.
A better position.
My faith will protect me. On my way. Concentrate. Ignite! Got to move.
Go for the throat.
Got to keep fighting. What should I do? Time to meet your maker.
Over here. Certainly.
What's that?
A lot of effort to hide one sarcophagus.
Thank you.
Here lies the guardian of tombs. Through knowledge comes atonement.
So he has spoken, and so thou standest before me, right as always. What a curious way to awaken. Now, I have a question for thee. What is the worth of a single mortal's life? Because that would be senseless. Wilt thou answer my question? So, I ask again, what is the worth of a single mortal life? It is mortality, just the same. Very well. I am satisfied. We have met, and I know thy face. We will see each other again at the proper time and place. Farewell. We have nothing more to discuss. Continue on my way, as if I were not here. I must attend this place after so many years away. We will see each other again soon. The mechanics of fate would be difficult to explain to one such as thyself. Regardless, it will occur.
On tippy toes. Yes, let's.
Well, hello.
Something over there.
Very well, then. I need a shovel to dig this up. I don't fancy giving away.
Anyone but us.
interior.
I don't fancy getting my hands dirty. I need a shovel. Is that room all right? It doesn't look all right.
You approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
Whatever you're doing, it's working wonders. Now, a quick little pull should do the trick. Oh. Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking, you were on the Nautiloid as well. And I can only assume you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region. No use sugarcoating it, is there? The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided. You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction. We're most certainly going to need a healer, and soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent! A parasite shared is a parasite halved, or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. For I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Don't touch me. There. All right.
There is work to do.
On my way.
What now? Go.
This bulk is far lighter than it should be with such a massive lock. As the lock opens, a loose page comes with it. Magic pulses from the parchment. What was once script is now an obliterated scrawl. You have a sense these are names, a list. But of what? Gods. These are the names of gods, once lost but now restored after the second sundering. The last three names in this book sit close together, but are so devastated by the scrawl as to be unreadable. Entire pantheons have dwindled and been reborn, silently recorded by this book.
Don't linger. Let's see. It's packed too tight. I'll need a shovel.
Why don't we just wait a while?
Make sure it's safe.
You're both twice as tall as me, but have half the bloody backbone.
But we don't know what that thing even is. And what about the crypt?
I'm telling you, it's a ship. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already. That's our ship. Well, in that case, come on, you lot. No point in getting killed. Second worm gets the cheese and all.
Second mouse gets the cheese, no?
Nobody's getting any damn cheese! Now move it!
You're more cunning than you look. I thought we had a fight on our hands.
Time and the elements have left the plaque unreadable.
There's something underneath here.
It's mine now.
Don't mind if I do.
Time to see what new horror's waiting for us.
My beautiful book! Everything all right out there? You sound a bit shaken, Moss. Hang on while I find the key.
Ha!
can't give up. You fight well. Perhaps our survival isn't such a distant prospect.
Let's be quick. I'll just help myself. Let's see.
Ancient, indecipherable text covers the plaque.
A dead tongue. Whoever worshipped her must be long gone. A little souvenir.
Which way to the nearest library?
Step lightly. Don't mind if I do.
You're not versed in magic, are you? No matter to worry the unlettered over. If you meet any elder wizards, let me know. There is a matter I'd like to seek advice on from a master.
the bloody lock.
All right.
How'd you get past Andor? Back off!
On my way.
Maneuver them.
Well, at least there's no skeletons this time.
On the hunt.
What's the plan? On the move.
Careful, I might. Let's move. It's mine now. People do this all day. No lock, no handle. How does it open? Certainly.
At least there's no skeletons this time.
What have we here? They won't know what bit them.
Clear off! We got here first.
Thank you.
What should I do? To go still.
Well, hello. Yes, let's.
You do not recognize the language on the plaque.
That might be worth a look. What is that?
Wouldn't take much to send that stone crashing downwards.
Of course it's dangerous. One of them carved up Zoru's whole squad.
So let's leave it.
And let the...
A welcome rest.
No. We take it to the grove. Zoru was right. Yellow as a toad and twice as ugly.
The thing's dangerous. Leave it for the goblins to kill.
And if it escapes, how will you... Oh. A guest.
Your skull pounds in response to the prisoner's white-hot stare. Her lips don't move, yet you hear her voice.
Get rid of them.
He's right. No one's safe if that thing goes loose. Not even us.
Damn A's!
Enough. Lower the trap. Ready your blade.
You've but one chance. Join me or die.
No!
You lying rat! On I go.
Shall be done.
My faith will protect me. On my way.
Some prey.
Let up.
Incendiary!
Professor, no! Come on, then.
The tadpole hasn't yet scrambled all your senses. Auspicious. But the longer we wait, the more it consumes. My people possess the cure for this infection. I must find a creche. You will join me.
Careful. She obviously sees your kindness as weakness. Don't let her take advantage.
I know my teachings. There are no half measures. If you wish to be rid of the tadpole, you must either be purified or beheaded. You have made an ally from Kresh Kalir. Few know such fortune. Call me Lazelle.
I'll trust your judgment, but I won't trust her. Not until I've gotten the measure of her.
You've a sharp tongue, elf. Would that your mind proved its equal.
Half elf. I suppose the finer details are lost on a creature like you.
Come. The Horned Ones mentioned a camp. One there, this Zoru, has seen Githyanki. A creche must be near. We will ask this Zoru where he has seen my kin.
Into my pocket. On the hunt. Quick stand. Let's see here. Broken. Must have been here a while. What's in here? Mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Best be careful.
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. You can't move. can't think. Thinking is mercifully done for you. It will be a joy to serve, to die for it an honor. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Your mind's fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Monster! Death is too good for it.
The boar grunts and eyes you warily with its beady eyes. The boar shuffles its trotters, unsure. Then it dashes away into the wilderness.
Indolence breeds madness.
My eyes haunt you!
Well, hello. Watch the shadows. Keep your distance, darling. On my way.
Mm.
Let's hope for gold. Don't mind if I do. For a skeleton key.
A Githyanki joining our company. Not a collaboration I'd have anticipated. But a welcome one, nonetheless.
Geich devourers. One strike could prove lethal.
Striking distance.
No time to waste. Let's finish this.
Mind if I do?
If I don't get my beauty sleep soon, I may just get a tad malcontent.
Done.
no one. Subtle steps. I wonder... I need a shovel to dig this up. This way. How about this? What's this? Certainly.
Lazelle has a dangerous look in her eyes. Let's just hope she reserves those impulses for any common foes.
We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly? We go our separate ways, of course. What else?
The ties that bind would be well and truly severed. If you must know, Baldur's Gate. And before you ask, no. I'm not telling you what I'm doing there, or who I'm meeting, or anything else.
Must I? Thinking about it won't help. We know what to do, so let's do it. Find a way to rid ourselves of these things. I'm not too hopeful that a Gith crash will actually prove our salvation, but worth keeping in mind. You're not the kind of company I'd keep willingly, but all things considered, you'll do.
And I haven't forgotten that you saved my life aboard the Nautiloid. Perhaps I'll be able to return the favor at some point.
So that's to say you'd like to pry a little. You do seem like the type, I must say. Just an observation. No offense taken. See? We're learning something about each other already. For instance, you're a quick-to-anger type, aren't you? Even less self-control than brains. There it is. Oh, don't pout. You walked right into that. And there's no harm in a little hot-bloodedness. No harm at all, in fact. You're like an eager, pale puppy. Let's not take things too fast. But who's to say? I might need a distraction some evening. These campsites do get cold. I suppose. I also suppose I'll have to rely on myself to stave off boredom. Was there something else? Fine. What's on your mind?
Let's have it.
Go ahead. I'm listening. Let's see. I hail from Waterdeep, City of Splendors. I am a wizard of considerable acclaim and scholar of exceptional accomplishment. I have a cat, a library, and a weakness for a good glass of wine. And if the mood takes me, I'm known to try my hand at poetry. There. Certainly. That I have a great respect for privacy, for instance, especially my own.
Chatter already, Tusky. I expect I am your first. Of course you haven't. They would have cut you from navel to neck. You are no less alien to me than I am to you. I know of your kind, but I do not often encounter them. That large, fleshy nose of yours looks like a mistake. Yes, best to keep quiet, lest any drivel leak from your lips. No matter. I do not intend to stay long in this place. I understand much beyond your comprehension. More to the point, I know the cure for our condition. It is imperative we locate a creche. You do well to observe more and question less. Yes, in great detail. It starts with a fever and memory loss. Then you start to hallucinate. Your hair falls out and you bleed from every orifice. Your bones will change form. Your jaw will split to allow room for four great tentacles. All skin will turn to gore and be shed to reveal new flesh underneath. Then you have ceased to exist, and a mind flayer is born. Words forged in steel. May your actions express the same metal. We must find my kind and be rid of the parasite. It's as simple as that.
The first symptoms should have long since started, though. That is what puzzles me. Yes, if you give it no further thought. But anomalies lead to surprises. Bad surprises. Besides, what hasn't happened may yet come to pass.
We meet again, as predicted. I shall be here in thy camp for whenever thou hast need of my services. Be assured, it is not by choice. A mending of the threads between life and death. Should thou or any of thy compatriots perish, I will cleave soul to body once more. Because it is my calling, there is little else to explain. Indeed. Farewell. Fate spins along as it should. Although thou dost not seem to be in need of my services. There are many answers to that question. None are important. Correct. No.
The forest, dark. Cold, foreboding.
Hello? Anyone there?
First, thou shalt not drink the blood of thinking creatures. Second, thou shalt obey me in all things.
Absolutely. It's just that I was kidnapped by a tentacle-faced...
Third, thou shalt not leave my side unless directed.
You can feel the old fear turning in your gut, but you force yourself to keep smiling, as you so often did before.
Fourth, thou shalt know that thou art mine. Pathetic, as always, but at least you know your place. You are mine, forever.
Cazador, your master. You have to get back to him quickly. If you're late, he'll flay you. Again. What will he say when he finds you can walk in the sunlight and he can't? And then it dawns on you. If you're free to walk in daylight, can you be free of Cassador too? Free of his rules?
First, thou shalt not drink of the blood of thinking creatures.
You look at your companions, sleeping, helpless. How badly do you need to know? You drift into the forest, hunting for anything with a pulse.